Epilepsy affects in Africa around 10 to 15 million people, and the prevalence of epilepsy in West Africa, in West African countries, is around 14.2 per 1,000 people, which is a huge prevalence compared to Western country in the world. And the highest prevalence reported is in Ivory Coast. And what is also important to mention is the treatment gap. So 80% of people with epilepsy in Africa in general, but especially in West Africa, do not receive the treatment or do not receive the proper treatment. And this treatment gap is increased by cultural beliefs, stigma, social limitation, financial constraint, and some comorbidities. So, what is the socioeconomic impact of epilepsy in West Africa? The first thing is the stigmatization is the first impact of epilepsy. School restriction, because parents usually fear of seizure in the school. For the driving license and other social professional restriction. And this lead to reduced activities, reduced financial income, and generally, there is no health coverage for the majority of people with epilepsy. And this will lead to no money to buy the treatment, no access to health facilities. So, association involved in the fighting against epilepsy in West Africa are working on the field, and some of them are affiliated to the EAA. And I will just mention few of them. It is not possible to put all the figure in the in one slide, so I have to mention Professor Gallo Diop, as Professor Samuel Reed mentioned, who was the leader of the implementation of epilepsy fighting in West Africa, especially in Senegal. But you have many other associations like Epilepsy Association of Sierra Leone in Nigeria, with Epilepsy Warrior and Epilepsy Foundation, and in Burkina Faso with the Burkinabese League Against Epilepsy. So, what is the contribution of EAA to help in terms of charity people with epilepsy? Actually, the EAA and the affiliated organization work on the field on education and sensitization, because it is important to mention that illiteracy rate in Africa region was about this is I think this number has improved now, but it was about 38.5% according to the WHO. EAA is working in terms of advocating for free education, improvement of social professional reinsertion, free access to anti-epileptic treatment, innovation with new technology, for example, the implementation of e-learning, e-consultation, and etc. So, what are the challenges? So, the main challenges are the burden of sociocultural belief, which is still a major problem. Most of patients will not come to the hospital because the thing or the family think that epilepsy is related to witchcraft. There is also challenges with collaboration with government authorities and some organizations to promote the complete well-being of people with epilepsy. So that's why we are hoping that with ECOWAS, we will have an agreement to work on the field to help people with epilepsy. So there is also challenging in access to health facilities and treatment, not only for anti-epileptic drug, because it is the main option, treatment option, but there are other options like surgery of epilepsy, ketogenic diet, vagus nerve stimulation, which are not at all already done in the West African region. So there is also some challenges in terms of legislation. So we need to work closely with government with governmental authorities to for help to help the people with epilepsy in access of specific facilities. So I will end with this picture. I've taken it on the website of Epilepsy in South Africa. Just to mention that people with epilepsy have a huge potential. We can help to develop this potential if we believe in them. So thank you for this opportunity. This is the end of my presentation.
Thank you so much, Dr. Mercy, for letting us crisscross through West Africa on the question of epilepsy through you. Just before I open the forum to the other members, I've learned that 14.2 out of every 1,000 are affected, not so much different from my country, Kenya, and also the treatment gap, so huge. And I think that treatment gap cuts across almost all African countries. You mentioned that the burden is so huge, or the number of affected is so huge in Ivory Coast. What could be the main reason Ivory Coast, out of the entire West Africa, having such huge number of those affected?
Okay, thank you for this. For the question, to talk about the, let's start with the hand. For the prevalence in Ivory Coast, the prevalence reported is 70 per 1,000 people, which is almost huge. And the reason, I think there are some reasons related to the type of study done, so methodological reason, but there is also some reason related to the like, let me say, the risk factors of epilepsy. And in Ivory Coast, and especially in the north of Ivory Coast and in Burkina Faso, you have neurocysticercosis, which is a frequent cause of epilepsy. And there are some other neuroinfectious disease that could increase the burden of the incidence of epilepsy in West African region. And what about the treatment gap? The treatment gap has for many other African countries is huge, but the specificity in West Africa is that first, as I told you, there is still a huge impact of sociocultural belief with witchcraft, with traditional treatment. Most of patients usually come in the hospital after trying for some time traditional treatment, etc. But there is also the problem in access to the treatment. For example, the health coverage for population is not implemented in almost all countries. So few people have health insurance, so they can easily get the treatment. But for the rest of the population, it is still a problem. And it is also important to note that the number of neurologists and of physician or nurses trained for the management of epilepsy is not that much. So people usually have to come to the main cities to have access to a neurologist or a general physician specialized in epilepsy treatment or a nurse specialized in epilepsy treatment. I don't know if I have answered the question.
Thank you. You've answered my question. Now to the rest of the members, kindly, if you have any comments or questions to Dr. Mercy, feel free to share.
Yes, I've got a question. Earlier on, we heard from Ms. Bimbola Oyeloyenu from the ECOWAS, and she talked about the need to work with organizations representing people with disabilities. referring particularly to ECOWAS. What opportunities do you see in the region, Dr. Mercy, and how could we use those opportunities as in alliance?
Thank you, Dr. Jacob, for this question. It is one of the important questions. I think with ECOWAS, we need to set up a plan of action together, because ECOWAS is already installed in localities in the field. So the ECOWAS will give us a base, a working base to reach. Because what is important for us is to reach the people with epilepsy wherever they are in the West African region. So with ECOWAS, we need to set a plan of action and maybe a memorandum of understanding to start working as soon as possible, because it's now that we need to start the job. Thank you very much, Jacob, for this question.
Thank you very much.
Any other person would like to share, comment, question? Okay, if there isn't, then I request we proceed. We've just learned from West Africa, the challenges remains the sociocultural beliefs, issues of stigma, finance, comorbidity issues, and isolation from education, driving, and all those challenges. But if all this is approached, tackled with the right medication and good support system socially, psychologically, people with epilepsy have great potential just